my Spanish Bible,
means the same thing,
self-control. It means that you have control of yourself. Well, how can you do, isn't that a fruit of the Spirit?
Yes, Paul says it's a fruit of the Spirit. So why does Peter say, add that?
How do you do that? How do you do that? Can y'all help me with that? Because I've been thinking about it, and I really can't figure it all out. You think I know everything, but I don't. I think there's something about the process that we read in James a moment ago that causes us, however it happens in our lives, Paul said, I worked harder than all of them. Harder than Peter, harder than all the apostles. He said, they added nothing to me early in his ministry. Can you imagine saying that? Wouldn't that sound kind of proud? You know, if you get a meeting with Billy Graham in his old age, and you have a meeting with several other leaders, and he said, after the meeting, you know, they're interviewing you, and they said, well, you met with Billy Graham, and who else can we put in there? Who else is your big guy? Is it Oral Roberts or John? Wait a minute. All right. Well, whoever you put in there, they interviewed me and said, they added nothing to me. I knew it all already. All their wisdom and all, they added nothing to me. That's what Paul said about that. He had a revelation of Jesus Christ, and God taught him the gospel, showed him those truths. So Paul says, I worked harder than all the rest, and I knew more than all the rest. But then he adds, not I, but the grace of God that was with me. In other words, Paul knew that it was God working in him, both to will and to do of his good pleasure. But this is the part that we have to engage in this week, self-control. And it ties together with perseverance. It's difficult to attain to without Christ. So I'm constantly praying, Lord, if you don't control me, I'm going to be out of control. If you don't control me. But yet at the same time, Peter says, you add, you participate in this process. So there comes a point in time where you have to say no. You have to resist the devil and he will flee from you. I think one day when we get to heaven and he starts rewarding everybody for what they've done, he's going to pull back the screen, so to speak, and he's going to say, do you see how I was working in you all of those times? Do you see what I was doing in you? You thought it was you, and let me show you, and I always talk about that fine line between him and me participating with him aggressively in accomplishing God's will. I think it's him and us doing it. I don't understand what you were going through, but you were going through it. He's got some other testimony you need to hear sometime when you come back. You can share some other stuff. God was working at the same time. God was loving. You know, we think that God doesn't love us when we're not being like 10 soldiers and towing the mark. He loves us no matter what. He wants you to be like Christ. So I put nevertheless, Peter reminds us to diligently work at this character trait. If you have a trouble with self-control, look at the next one. You're going to have a trouble with perseverance. Perseverance, go ahead. This word is used throughout the New Testament over and over and over. It's also used in Galatians. It's used over and over and over. It's composed of two words. You've heard this before probably. To stay or to remain. And then the other word is under. That's what the word means. So when you're persevering, you can't get out of the trial. You can't say, God, zap me and take me out of this. Otherwise, you don't develop perseverance. You understand what I'm saying? Tribulation produces perseverance. That's Romans chapter 5. I thought for sure that I had that verse in this, but I don't. Romans chapter 5 says, turn there, I can't quote it. Turn to Romans chapter 5, verse 1, and look at it. Yeah, I can. Tribulation produces patience, patience experience, and experience hope. Can you find that for me? You're putting up verse 1. Put up verse 2. Am I wrong? Do I have the wrong address? Or that? Verse 3. And not only that, but we glory in tribulations, knowing that tribulation produces perseverance. Here it is again. Perseverance, character, there's that word, and character, hope. And hope does not disappoint us.